Gosh, this rides nicely. Gear change is nice, but my goodness, talk about high geared. It is incredibly high geared. You need a boulevard to ride this. So if I'm being a tourist in the Yorkshire Dales or anywhere, forget it. Definitely one for the boulevard. Brakes work. So you can have a better look at it than on the previous video. My plan is to mix up some cream paint and attend to these bits of the what were white. I'll just put a little bit of brown in some white. That should arrive me at the correct colour. I'm glad that these beautiful little pieces of graphic design are intact. Oh, what a lovely typeface, look at that. Gorgeous. And then you've got the same thing in miniature down here. Absolutely lovely that. On the chain case, of course, the classic Raleigh all steel bicycle decal. We have an oiler. Yum yum, I love those. That will be polished, that's brass. We have an external run cable with the brazed on boss for the pivot wheel, classy. The old Raleigh hooked end brakes, which are a one piece lever cable and caliper piece. There's a clip missing, that's fine, I've got clips. So I'll keep that original. Royal Carmine, the same colour that was used from the 50s right through to the 70s. I need to get some of that. I need to find a match for it. I need to work on that. The white tail is only there, but I think it might have been, I don't know. When this bike was made, they were still mandatory. It was the last year that they were mandatory, so it will have had one. It seems to have had the minimum. I can't see any traces of having had one. Everything in order down here. It's had some mudguard stays fitted, retrofitted, for a standard bike where the lug to mount them would have been at the top of that dropout, just behind where the seat stay joins, and so it would have needed a longer stay. This always happens with this Raleigh dropout. You need longer legs on a rack and shorter stays for the mudguard. I've probably got some the right length, but really that is nitpicking. Endrick rims, 40 hole. And the hub, it says 60. It says March 1960, which is not the right date for a Boulevard Tourist, I don't think. Because this is going to be a keeper, probably a permanent keeper, and it's got Endrick rims and cheapo mild steel spokes. Now I've found it's got the wrong date hub, then I feel vindicated in my decision, which is to fit a pair of Superb wheels. I have some Superb wheels. I've got some more coming actually. A regular subscriber has very kindly offered to donate a pair of Superb wheels. He's down in to the south of Manchester, so I need to sort that out. I've got to take the Humber to Manchester anyway, and some rims for somebody who seems to have forgotten. I will give it superb wheels, which is the Raleigh pattern, and they're Raleigh stamped as well. Stainless steel spokes, and the benefit in the back being it will have the hub generator as well. So I will put a pair of lights on it, definitely. It's going to be called a Tourist, it should have lights. You see the mismatch in colour here? I don't think it's got later mudguards, I think it's just that the paint has faded differently. This paint is over a black bondarised undercoat. This paint will not be. It's probably just over a grey primer or something, or even over white. And so as age has got to it and UV has got to it, it's faded differently. I haven't even looked in there, but certainly in there is some evil gearing. We've got a 12 sprocket on the back, something about the feel of it. That's going to be changed when I change the wheels. Now this gives me more confidence that these are original mudguards, because it's got Sir Walter Raleigh on there, not a heron, which means earlier. And it does have herons on the front forks, not Sir Walter's. One thing I do need to put on it is one of those brilliant Raleigh Industries stands. I have one, so that will go on pronto. I'm sick of sitting around holding the bike up like this. And I'll raise the bars up as high as I can, but that might be about it. I felt on the way down here that they just needed angling back a few degrees. It needs a bell, and it's going to have an Icebrook 66 on it. What colour I don't know, it'll depend what I've got. I don't have any white saddles. A red and white saddle would be nice. The cream grips are fine. If not original, they're certainly period. The correct shifter with 3 and 4 speed adaptable, and L, N and H. Low, normal and high. And notice it's got one of these, I like these. And they're very 1950s, the high mount lamp bracket. I would like to have this on my Dawn Tourist, but you can't put those on a Dawn because of the brake rods getting in the way. I like the look of them when they've got the headlamp high up like that. So this will be getting a lamp on there. I might have to go second-hand lamp shopping depending on what they've got. But it needs probably something smaller, the smaller size of Sturmey Archer. So there we are. There is the Boulevard Tourist. I hope you'll join me for the renovation project videos. I'm doing the Superb first because that's a quick recommission. And then I don't know which of these two. I think probably this one second, because it needs less. It needs a good service and the paintwork tidying up. Whereas the Elizabethan needs a chain case and things like that. So yeah, probably this one. And probably get some superb wheels in it. Tyres, of course it needs white walls. Absolutely it needs white walls. I'm seeing a brown or tan Brooks 66. I have a pair of white walls that are slightly creamed down. They're not that bright, garish blue-white that the new ones come in. They're Michelin World Tours as well, so they'll go nicely in there. Nice stainless steel shiny wheels, the creamy white walls, the cream accents redone. Paint, the top tube is the worst part, but I don't know how much I'll do. If I can get some paint primarily for the the other bike, the Elizabethan, it would be tempting to do some of this, but then I'd get carried away. I'd end up spraying the whole chain case, and come on, this is the lovely original bike. I'm starting to look at it now and seeing a pair of creamy white ivory coloured Bluemel's popular mudguards, or Bluemel's special mudguards. Yeah, the ones that are a similar shape to this with the ridge down the middle, but they're celluloid and they come to more of a taper at the front. I think I might have some. If I have some, I'm very tempted to hold them up against this and see what I think. I'm pretty sure I've got some red ones, but that'll be a different shade of red on red. I can see the cream though, can you? With the creamy white wall tyres. Oh, that'll look nice. Anyway, enough. Thank you for watching. Please join me for the forthcoming videos of renovating these three bikes and taking them for rides, and I'm sure you're going to be seeing an awful lot more of this one. Probably the Elizabethan as well, I really like that. But this is just a peach. I'm so happy to get this. So please remember to stay subscribed. Check that you are subscribed. Subscribe if you aren't, so that you don't miss any of the fun. And as always, if you are able to contribute anything to the channel to keep us doing fun things like this, then please consider a small donation by PayPal or Patreon. See you very soon for the next one. Bye bye now.